Today is Park-a-Palooza, and we are using what we learned in the Park System Master Plan to create individual park plans for 9 Bloomington parks. Starting in 2020, we worked with the community, city council, and staff to create the Park Master Plan, which is a high-level planning document that helps set priorities and guide investments for city parks and helped us really learn what's important to people in Bloomington to see in their parks. The fact we have too many diamond fields, maybe too many tennis courts, but are lacking walking loops in our trails, something people asked for. We're lacking other amenities and experiences that people would like to see in their parks. The event is a working day with our consultant team from Confluence, with other team members of theirs from around the country, with staff from many other departments, helping us use the public input to create the concept plans for each park.
And when we're focusing on natural resource management in parks, we have to look at all of the different aspects of things that interact with it. Water is a big one, of course, but there's also the human side of that local land ecosystem and the animals, the birds, the squirrels, and things that visit the parks. Natural resource management is a huge priority for the city of Bloomington. It's a complicated issue. As we're moving through our parks master plans and updating the parks, things like water resources and how to better integrate and show respect to that land community and how we're managing it in the long run is a big component of what we're doing. Setting it up now in these design concepts and how the human aspect interacts with these natural resource components is the key to make sure that we can continue this relationship with our human community members and the landscape in which we are a part.
Next, we'll finalize 2 concept plans for each parks and go back to the community and ask for input on what do you like, what do you not like, what's missing, and combine that feedback and what we have in the 2 concepts into an individual concept plan for each park. That concept plan for each park will help us financially plan for improvements in the future and then also allow us to incrementally make improvements to these parks in a planful way based on what the community would like to see.